When I grew up, I did lack in confidence quite a lot, and that's what kind of spurred me into the gym. When I joined the gym, and I could see changing, I could see my body changing, and I was starting to develop the six-pack, and I did start to feel more confident in myself and more in day-to-day life as well. It was bringing me out. So the more I trained and the more I developed, the more I got confident with myself. So that's where I am today, yeah. That's where I just keep pushing and pushing and, yeah. So I've always trained in gyms like this since I've started, and this is how I became to train like I do. I enjoy it and I feel at home here, and yeah, I can train well, and a lot of my friends train like this, and a lot of my friends compete in the bodybuilding world, so I like to train with them as well. And even though I don't want to get into the bodybuilding sector, I've always trained as like a bodybuilder. I went up to nearly 14 stones, which now I'm only 12 stone 8. When I was looking back in the mirror, I kind of thought that's not the option for me, because I'm not the tallest of guys. So yeah, I got considerably more, but no, it didn't look brilliant. It was more on the fat side, I'd say, looking back now. It wasn't suiting my frame, it wasn't suiting the way I looked, so that's when I decided to look into more dieting and to see if I could get lean gains as opposed to getting mass size. So that's when it all started, and that's when I enjoyed started dieting and seeing change in my body. Basically, not just going for mass size, not looking on a scale, looking on the weight scale and thinking, wow, that's hit 14 stone now, I'm looking brilliant. I was more on the fact that getting gains through muscle, so you're looking leaner. So that's when I decided to focus more on leaner gains and keep my endurance there. Now I've dropped the weight down and I do a lot more high intensity training. I found that my endurance and my general health is a lot better. Aches and pains have gone. I feel a lot better in myself. I dropped from heavy weights, from low reps, from 8 to 12 reps, to more full body workouts, full circuits, 20 reps. So it's high intensity, so I'm sweating a lot more. I've got a heart rate going a lot faster. And yeah, I tend to burn the body fat as well as maintaining the muscle, why I train like that. I'm happy with the size I am. I just obviously like to always improve on definition and stuff like that. I know I'm very fortunate, obviously. It does come down to genetics with what's obviously with being blessed with the genetics to get a six pack. But not taking away that I do train them very hard, and it was something I was very obsessed with as a kid. I don't know why, a midsection, I always wanted a midsection throughout my training lifespan so far. I've always wanted that, so I always focused a lot on my abs workout. I only train them twice a week at the most, but that's something I always train. I think my physique is very achievable. It does take a lot of dedication in the fact that you do have to eat your meals very often. You have to shy away from the junk food, which I found very hard at first. When I first started, that was my biggest mountain I had to climb, was to get over the food side. I believe the nutrition side is a lot more important than the training side. Keeping your carbs out, keeping your carbs clean as opposed to eating junk food and stuff, and watching what you put in, your calorific value you're putting into your body and what you're burning off on a certain day-to-day basis. A lot of manipulating the body and a lot of shaping your body is what you put in, is the fuel you put in, which is your food. I think it's more of a realistic goal to the average male and to the average female who want to train and want to stay healthy. They look at that and see that as a realistic goal. It's still very surreal being that guy on that poster. It's been 8 months now where it's all come crazy from being an average plumber to being that guy on the poster. Yeah, it's still sinking in, but it's an amazing feeling, and I don't take it for granted at all, and I'm still working hard, and it just kind of, when I see that, it makes me want to go further, and it makes me want to push even further, which is brilliant for my training and for me to stay focused and keep focused.